What's up, everybody? Andrew Mahone here with Darium's Competitive Pokemon, back with another Card of the Day series. Today's Card of the Day is Tapu Lele GX from the Guardians Rising set. Tapu Lele GX is already famous, doesn't need hardly any introductions. It is probably the most powerful Pokemon GX released to date, and it's all because of this amazing Wonder Tag ability. There's no talking about Tapu Lele GX without talking about Wonder Tag, but I'm going to go ahead and get started with some of the other stats first. First of all, Tapu Lele GX is a basic GX Pokemon boasting 170 hit points, which is pretty good for a Pokemon GX, and especially when you compare it to other Pokemon in the past that have had similar draw abilities or, you know, supporter fetching abilities. We got Jirachi EX, which only had 90 hit points, a huge liability on the bench. You have Shaymin EX, which obviously a little bit different. It refills your hand to 6 cards, but only had 110 hit points. Tapu Lele GX having such a powerful ability with a whole 170 hit points is a huge asset and should not be underrated. It is also psychic type, but the psychic typing doesn't really come into play too often because energy drive does not attack for weakness or resistance, and psychic, being a psychic Pokemon, usually psychic Pokemon will have psychic or dark weaknesses. Tapu Lele GX has got no weakness and no resistance, so being a psychic Pokemon really just allows it to operate under Wobbuffet's ability lock, which is a pretty nifty little nuance that comes into play sometimes that you will see. Tapu Lele GX also has a very awesome retreat cost of 1, which means that it is very easy to get it out of the active position. So let's check out the ability and the 2 attacks on Tapu Lele GX. First of all, that ability, Wonder Tag. When you play this Pokemon from your hand onto your bench during your turn, you may search your deck for a supporter card, reveal it, and put it into your hand. Then shuffle your deck. So, Wonder Tag, amazing ability. It allows you to handpick the supporter you would like for turn out of your deck, and you can play it that turn, or you can save it for the following turn. Just a very good ability, allowing you to search supporters out of your deck. Obviously, draw supporters are the primary way to draw cards in the Pokemon trading card game. They also have some very powerful effects. You can pull out Guzma to end games by bringing out a Pokemon on the opponent's bench. You could grab a Team Flare Grunt if you need to remove an energy from your opponent's active Pokemon. You could grab something like an Acerola if you needed to heal your active Pokemon which had been damaged. You can grab a Hexmaniac now in expanded format if you want to shut off your opponent's abilities for turn. If you need to draw aggressively, you could grab a Professor Sycamore or Professor Juniper. If you need to limit your opponent's strategies, you could grab a Getsis or an End. There are just so many options. As many supporter cards as there are, this is how many options you have with Wonder Tag. Talk about the newly released Kiawe in Fire decks. You can Wonder Tag for a Kiawe on the first turn of the game to get fire energy accelerated to your fire Pokemon. It is just such an amazing ability, and it's incredible that it was printed on such a powerful card with some pretty good attacks as well. So let's take a look at the attacks. Energy Drive for 2 colorless energy does 20 damage times the number of energy attached to both active Pokemon. And like I said previously, this damage is not affected by weakness or resistance. So Energy Drive is very reminiscent of Mewtwo EX. For anybody that's been in the game for a while, you may remember Mewtwo EX was a very dominant card in its time, which had the exact same attack, except it was called X-Ball, right? The famous X-Ball attack. X-Ball, however, did hit for weakness and resistance, and Mewtwo EX was weak to psychic. So the difference here being that Mewtwo was really the only counter to Mewtwo, and Mewtwo was the best thing at knocking out a Mewtwo in the Pokemon trading card game. As you can see here, Energy Drive, not quite as powerful because it doesn't hit for weakness. Obviously, would be very good if you could use Energy Drive to quickly dispatch Garbodor, Trash Lance Garbodor. That would be really excellent. Unfortunately, we're not able to do that. That being said, Energy Drive is just a great vanilla attack, easily powered up with double colorless energy, can be used in any deck that Tapu Lele is played in, so long as they play energy cards, because, you know, you could just slap any energy on this thing and energy drive and do some pretty decent damage early game. You know, maybe you start your Tapu Lele GX, or maybe you just need a supplemental attacker in the middle of the game. Tapu Lele GX fills these holes very nicely and is just a all-around great attacker to have, as well as a supporter Pokemon. A lot of times when you played Pokemon like Jirachi EX or Shaymin EX, in order to assist the draw of your deck, that Pokemon would be a sitting duck on the bench just waiting for your opponent to take it out. Tapu Lele GX, when it uses its Wonder Tag ability, actually strengthens your board position a lot of the times, because you can use it as a backup attacker should you need to, which is just an awesome, awesome ability that it has to be a backup attacker and a support Pokemon. It does have a GX attack, Tapu Cure GX. Tapu Cure GX is usable with a psychic energy, and it reads, heal all damage from two of your benched Pokemon. So obviously, because it requires a psychic energy, Tapu Cure GX is not going to be usable in all decks, but it is usable in quite a few. You could use it in an expanded Trevenant deck, since that deck does play psychic energy. You could also use it in an Espeon Garbodor deck. You could also use it in a Drampa Garbodor deck. You could also use it in any deck that plays rainbow energy. So it is accessible in quite a few archetypes, and I expect Tapu Cure GX to continue to see some play in the future, especially in the expanded format, where we do have Trevenant, which is a big, big threat in expanded format, and really thrives by heavily damaging benched Pokemon with that Trevenant Breaks Silent Fear attack, spreading 3 damage counters to each of your opponent's Pokemon. Tapu Cure GX can be a very viable strategy to heal your bench Pokemon and prevent them from being chipped away by the opponent's Trevenant. So I think that's a pretty cool interaction that we're going to see coming up in the expanded format relatively soon. So Tapu Lele GX is just a format defining card, incredible card that goes in almost every single deck. You know, obviously it's not being played in Greninja Break, and it's not going to be played in some very few decks that just want to only play non-EX or GX Pokemon. But other than that, Tapu Lele GX is going to be in just about everything. So you might ask, what's the right number of Tapu Lele GX to play? Tapu Lele GX is a very expensive card. I mean, this full art version is hovering around $50 right now, and it is not very easy to get a hold of. So I highly recommend going out and trying to get at least 2 or 3 copies of Tapu Lele GX if you plan on playing competitively in the upcoming season. That being said, I have seen some Drampa Garbodor decks piloted by world-class players at the World Championships. Some of them were playing 4 copies of Tapu Lele GX, just like Tord did to win the North American International Championships this year. So having a full set of Tapu Lele GX is obviously going to be optimal for the upcoming season. Unfortunately, sometimes the Pokemon trading card game is just an expensive game to play. But I think if you save your money and plan accordingly, you know, maybe you can save up for at least 2, and 2 copies of Tapu Lele GX should be enough to get you able to play most competitive decks in the upcoming season. Though, like I said, a full playset is optimal, because some decks, like that Drampa Garbodor deck, do run 4 copies, though you can get away with 3. I think that 3 is going to be a pretty optimal number coming up in the future of the standard format. Between 3 and 4 could be optimal, just because Versus Seeker is rotating out of standard format. So you're going to want options to select your supporter card for turn throughout the course of the game. So I think 3 copies of Tapu Lele GX is probably going to be great for a lot of decks. As you can see, even the World Championship winning deck, that Gardevoir GX deck, did play 3 copies of Tapu Lele GX. I played 3 copies of Tapu Lele GX in my Gardevoir GX deck as well. I think a lot of decks are going to be running between 2 and 4 copies of this card. So I think it's also just going to be incredible in the expanded format. I'm really excited to see what kind of things Tapu Lele GX can do in the upcoming expanded format with even more supporter cards to fetch out of the deck. I don't think Tapu Lele GX will be played in as high of numbers in expanded format as it is in standard format, since expanded format does have powerful cards like Computer Search, that Ace spec, which allows you to search out any card in your deck, as well as Versus Seeker, obviously, allowing you to fetch supporter cards from the discard pile as well. So I think Tapu Lele GX, though it will be very strong in expanded format, will be limited to one or two copies in most decks. So thank you all for checking out my card of the day video. Let me know what you all think of Tapu Lele GX in the comments below. Like the video, subscribe to the channel. Peace.